This is happening all over.
So we were just talking about, you know, that the message is unclear from here. And I think that if you do come down here, anybody could walk by here and see what the message is just by looking at the signs or walking in and talking to all these people. But when we talk about the demands and the people not understanding what the demands are, the reality is that we're not going to make demands, because demands are dependent upon the other people acting and doing something and following through. And we know the government's not going to do that, and we know businesses aren't going to do that. So there are going to be no demands. The other part of making demands is that implicitly in that is a statement that we want them in power, and that they are the people with the solutions. So we're not going to be asking for demands, but what we are going to be issuing is goals, because goals are things that we want to accomplish. So when the time comes, and with this movement becomes big enough and large enough, which it will after this, I mean large enough and loud enough, what's going to happen is we're not going to issue demands, and even our goals are going to be overshadowed. What we're going to do is we're going to issue instructions, because this is all about this campaign season when elected officials are telling us the American people want this and the American people want that, or telling us what we can't and we can't do. What's happening with this movement is that we're going to take the narrative over, and we're going to tell people what we want. Because we do represent the 99% of the people that aren't being served, so you can listen to the campaign.
So what's the essence? What do you think? What's the essence of the problem that you're trying to address?
Well, I don't think that this would be nearly as popular a movement or as growing a movement if there were clear choices in the campaign. There are no clear choices in this campaign, and we saw,
Well,
with Obama, you had people who expected change regardless of whether they voted for him or not, because people that were voting for him wanted change, and people that were voting against him didn't want change. So either way, both sides, 100% of the people that voted, expected change to happen, and it didn't. So when we look at what's happening here, you're seeing people from all different backgrounds who are organizing themselves around similarities instead of differences.
So what's the common gripe?
I don't know if there's a common gripe, because this really isn't an angry movement as much as it's a movement looking for solutions. But the common issue that brings everybody here is this visceral recognition that there's a problem in this country that needs to be solved.
And the problem is?
The problem is that the government is non-responsive. I think the three initial issues that brought people out here, the very early people, was they wanted a preservation of freedom of speech, which would include on the internet and net neutrality.
So if the government starts to pull the plug on the internet in some way, how are people here going to react to that?
Well, the government can't pull the plug on the internet, because we have things like the Pentagon and defense system and police.
Well, to whatever. Right.
It's very hard to do.
Censor it. Okay. I don't mean to
But when you look at censorship, then look at what happened in Egypt when they tried to take it down, and groups like Anonymous went in and took care of it.
So people from this group in this congregation. These people are going to freak if the government starts censoring the internet, starts shutting down websites.
Well, no, because I don't think, I think the thing that you're seeing here, the government is kind of very uncomfortable, because we don't have a leader they can talk to. And the mass media is seeing that we're organizing around similarities, so there aren't people fighting that they can take advantage of.
Okay, so what are the issues?
The issues are up front. The things that brought people here were freedom of speech.
Who are you, first of all? I mean, tell whatever.
I'm my own political leader. There is nobody
What's
here.
What's your sign say? Just get his sign just so we have a little contact.
Yeah.
I've had different signs every day, but this is one especially for Mayor Mike. Was clearly carrying out, you know, orders of the people who fund him and the people who buy the
Federal
the
Reserve
units
Federal
for their Reserve. Traders.
Federal Reserve.
Well, you know, the Federal Reserve too, but you know, the Federal Reserve, once we, you know, deal with the banks, the Federal Reserve, I'm sure, will be dissolved, because 70% of the people supported auditing the Fed. But there's another example of our government not responding.
Would you say that this movement, let's call it, boils down to a non-responsive, quote, representative government?
Well, I think what it boils down to is, and if you look at the government and you look at the mass media, what it boils down to is we're not playing their game anymore. We're here and we're not talking to them. We don't have oppressed people who are trying to get the mass media in here. We don't have people standing and asking why they're not here. We're ignoring them. We're streaming out from 9 different computers there, internationally, all over
but
the world.
Is regular press, I mean, you're talking to regular NBC, ABC?
People do, but it's not like there's a leader that comes here. I mean, if you even look at the politicians, there are politicians who are endorsing the movement, but none of them are coming down here. None of them have their picture here, because they'll be run right out of here.
Didn't that happen with
Charlie Rangel got run out of here.
Yeah, good. Yeah. Tax cheat.
And John Lewis got, you know.
That's a corrupt assembly.
Well, run them all out.
Well, he came down and he wanted to speak. And we have something called General Assembly here, where people stand on a little platform, a little stone platform, that's maybe 2.5 feet high, and you talk, and I told you about the people's mic, where the crowd responds and answers back what the person is saying. You can hear in the background right now.
Now, to answer the the allegation from certain people, certain sectors, that the movement is very socialistic. It's dominated by the unions. It's dominated by George Soros, whatever you want to say. Basically, moving towards socialism. Is that accurate?
Well,
not necessarily.
Let me go right through this. I mean, the one thing you'll see, as far as the unions go, and if people listen, and this is a movement about listening, because you'll always see conversations with you, listen to what the unions say. They endorse the movement, and they march in solidarity with it, but they're not part of it. If their union members want to come in and be individuals in here, they can. If their leaders want to come in and be individuals, they can. But there is no group that's coming in here as a unified and as a single unit.
Because it seems like even with the Democrat Party, like they're trying to kind of say this is our movement.
Right. So let's look at that. They're all coming out and saying that they endorse this. But there are also Republicans too. Mitt Romney came out and said that we had some right ideas. Ron Paul did too. So everybody's trying to get on this because this is the movement and this is the story. So you see these politicians coming out and endorsing this, but you don't see them down here. You see them all saying we're doing good things, but you don't see them down here. You don't see them at any of the protests.
Well, they're probably still thinking it's going to go away.
So well, no, they're not down here because, one, we don't want them here. We don't want leaders here, politicians to come down and make a speech and then go on TV and say, well, I was down there and I talked to the people and this is what they want.
You don't want them benefiting from
it. They don't speak.